interesting how that light's on in the middle of the afternoon. Looks like that snow they were talking about never came too. It says it's supposed to rain today. I guess this snow will all be gone in a short while, huh? Watch me say this and then tomorrow, poof, blizzard. Quick comment, when you guys were saying you thought the camera, it looked out of focus or blurry at times, like when I was walking through it, so you're wondering if something was wrong with the new camera, hopefully not. I think that part that you're talking about is just the camera basically having auto exposure, so when it gets really bright, like in the background for example, then the shutter speed tries to compensate on the brightest spot, so as a result, while the background will look normal, it'll make the front look a lot darker, and because this camera's an action camera, it's not very good in low light, it'll result in things like the blurriness. I think that's what you're talking about, because that seems pretty normal. So for a test for people who are noticing that, I think today, for example, since it's cloudy, no crazy light, you'll see basically a consistent picture. You won't see like that sudden blurriness like all of a sudden. I guess funny enough, like with yesterday and capturing that squirrel that was going crazy in many ways, I wouldn't have been able to capture stuff like that without a camera like this. And when I was doing the editing, I was like, is that the exact same squirrel like from the previous day? I think it was, just based on the characteristics of it, because you can see it's kind of funny, even though it ran for the food that people were throwing, once it got it, it ran right back to me. He's like, hey, I remember you. And that first crazy thing I read today, how's this? It says, dash camera captures plane narrowly missing traffic north of Toronto. So you can see, for some reason, this plane just goes whizzing by, and a car that has the dash cam on basically captured it all. It says here, dash cam footage captures the terrifying moment when a small plane narrowly misses the vehicle's front hood as it careens across a busy road north of Toronto. Police said the single-engine plane lost control right after taking off from a runway at the Buttonville Airport in Markham, Ontario, around 2 p.m. on Tuesday afternoon. Investigators say the Cirrus SR-20 aircraft didn't gain enough altitude during the takeoff and crashed through a fence before narrowly missing traffic on 16th Avenue near Highway 404 where the dash camera was taken. So apparently people were learning how to fly, I think. It says the privately owned plane then crashed into a ditch on the other side of the road where it sustained significant damage to its nose and sides, police said. Mitchell said a male instructor and a female student who were inside the plane were uninjured in the crash. No motorists were injured in the collision either. As to what they were potentially learning in terms of the flying, it says they were training a maneuver called touch and go. So you come into land and you basically do a landing and you slow down and accelerate and then you do a go another takeoff. It's an easy way to get a bunch of takeoffs and landings in if you are doing maneuvers, but in this case something went wrong. So if that means anything for people who actually flies planes and all that. I said it before, I'm just surprised how many aviation accidents or incidents there actually are. I just never paid attention to it until I started flying the drones and then people started making like a stereo and big deal about it. Ah man, the rain started to come down. But in terms of things like drones and deaths and all that, I actually did read a story recently that it was caused by a drone in terms of someone dying, but it's probably not what any of you were expecting or the reasons why people say those things are deadly and all that. It says here, two brothers electrocuted, one killed trying to remove drone from tree. So from what I gathered in the story, they were basically flying a drone and then it crashed and got stuck. But where it got stuck was in between some power lines, and so they tried to get it down at first but were unsuccessful, and they used a wooden pole, like it was self-made, didn't work, and then apparently the neighbor suggested or gave them a metal pole. And because they gave them a metal pole to try afterwards, it made contact with the electric line, it basically electrocuted the person, they went flying back, and I guess from where they landed afterwards due to the trauma and all that, the person basically passed away unfortunately. Like more specifically, it says, the shock knocked the brothers over onto a nearby storm drain. And as a result of that, he died from the wounds. Such an unfortunate incident, huh? It's probably not something you think about either when you're just trying to get it down. It probably just goes over your head. Although an interesting note, it wasn't that they tried to get it in the exact same day. It says here, he said the drone had been stuck in the tree at least 3 weeks. So they had some time, I suppose, to think about whether or not they wanted to bring it down. I would imagine for most people, you would try something at least to get it back because those are pretty expensive, like over $1,000 and all that. But again, for most of the stuff I read in terms of drones, if there is anything that caused like death, and like this is more of a freak accident. But even like when you see it on news, like you can see it in the screen grab from the news thing here, it says, drone death. Like, that's the actual title. Like, I don't know if you could necessarily categorize that as a drone death in a sense where it gives people the perception like somebody flew the drone into you and you died kind of thing. Because even if someone died on an airplane, let's just say it's food poisoning, I don't think the title would be airplane death. It'll probably be something like food poisoning on board an airplane or whatever flight. Because like with that first story, like that incident, man, I'd rather have a drone flying by than a huge airplane like that in terms of like a accident or incident in that case. But the small one anyway is like what most people fly. Are these leaves like left over from the fall or are they starting to grow for the spring? This rain is like on and off, on and off. Couldn't get that much flight in today. All right, see you guys later.